Hi, this is Ishita Datta, a legal intern at Lexis & Company, and today I will be talking about a topic is that if someone receives a legal notice, how is someone supposed to react to such a situation? Receiving a legal notice can be scary. Here are a few steps to help you think through the situation. First things first, be calm. It is natural to get worked up when you get a legal notice. But realize that there is no pending litigation at this point. There is only a threat of being sued. So accept delivery of the legal notice. Another thing to ensure that don't refuse to accept the notice. Lots of times what happens that the recipient may refuse to sign or tell a family member to convey that they are not available to receive the notice. So this doesn't do any good. It is a settled principle of law that refusal to accept summons or notice is deemed as valid service. The recipient will be assumed to have knowledge of the contents of the summons or notice. So legal notice is only an expression of the grievances and the demands of the sender. Thus, you should contact the sender to clear any misunderstandings or if they want to settle. So if the person has sent a notice on frivolous grounds, don't be worried. Frivolous suits and criminal cases are seen as a menace by the Honorable Supreme Court, and courts can order exemplary cause for such harassment. So there are four options to file a suit for defamation or suit for damages, which are also available. Then you should look for a legal representation. Next, contact a lawyer. Give them a copy of the notice and all the relevant documents. If you are not keen on spending for legal consultation, examine the situation and trace all the events to understand why the notice has been served. If you can look for the legal provisions to ascertain whether the notice is justified or not, this will be a financial wise step as well. If you hire an advocate later, this would ease the work for everyone. Ideally, try to resolve the dispute and avoid litigation. Arrange meetings between the sender of the notice and yourself and work out the situation. Litigation can take some time, money and also the mental space. You have to take leave from your work and other responsibilities. Although in some circumstances, court can exempt personal attendance. So after that, you should always reply to a legal notice. Though you are not legally obligated to reply to a legal notice, but it is advisable to reply. It is preferable if the reply is drafted by a lawyer. So if you don't reply and the sender approaches the court, you might have a weaker claim under law, and the court will only get to hear the opposite party's claim in the first instance. So given due to the consideration to the background of circumstances and the draft a reply, you should always state your position in a polite yet firm manner. Don't make your reply unnecessarily harsh. Rely on correct data. Examine all your documents, communications and the events that have transpired, and show the flaws in the notice that has come to you. So if you have a subsisting agreement, then refer to the mandatory dispute resolution clause, usually an arbitration clause, and give your reply as per the contract terms. Then the tone of the reply significantly impacts the dispute also. So it is better to keep your voice conciliatory. Express your intention to settle explicitly if this doesn't hamper your future course of action. Pay attention to the facts. A mistake often done by the individuals while drafting by themselves, entering data correctly. In the case of Mohammed Irfan versus Velu Kanan, the complainant had entered an incorrect check number in his legal notice. The High Court laid down that such mistake in commercial activities cannot be termed as mere typographical one, and held that the complainant has not fulfilled the obligation of serving a notice to the accused. Thus, never reply in a hurry. Take your adequate time to examine all the documents and laws relevant to the matter. So when you are giving a reply, it will help in the case the matter goes to the court, and when the court is deciding on the facts, then having a reply to the legal notice gets the procedure fast-tracked. Next is, don't admit to claims unnecessarily. One thing which you must keep in mind is that do not make any admissions which goes against you later on. The reply would be a relevant one if the litigation is pursued later. For example, a notice for replacement of damaged or defective goods is served upon a seller. In his reply, the seller admits that the consumer had visited the authorized service center under his control and the defect couldn't be rectified at that time. This statement by the seller will operate as an admission as well as a previous statement for the purposes of the Indian Evidence Act 1872. During litigation, if the seller makes a statement contrary to the aforementioned, the court may be inclined towards giving a decision in favor of the plaintiff. Further, the reply must also contain a specific and distinct denial of facts alleged in the notice in addition to a blanket denial of the whole notice. So any vague statement may cause misunderstandings or become an admission later. So check the law. This is a very important thing. Examine the settled principles of the law with regards to the facts concerned. If defenses are available, then mention them. But if the law is not justifying your case, then it is best to consult an advocate. Say the claim for repayment of money made by the sender was time barred or the issuer himself had breached the contract. The reply must contain such facts as defenses in addition to any or other grounds suitable to the situation. Where the reply is equipped with valid defenses, it is probable that the sender of the notice actually never invokes the legal remedies he previously threatened. Inserting defenses in the reply may also induce the opposite party to take a conciliatory approach instead of a hostile approach. The next thing is look for counterclaims. Look for counterclaims and insert them to make your case stronger. If there is something which the other side has done which puts them into fault, make sure to point that out. It is also advisable that all cards should be opened at once. Only as much as defenses should be taken as are sufficient to break the confidence of the issuer of the notice. Revealing too much will be allowed the opposite party to know what he was unaware of previously. So if the notice seeks an immediate action, respond with a date that gives sufficient opportunity to investigate the matter. Further, the reply must also seek clarifications from the sender of the notice if the same was not understandable. So where the recipient is aware that the issuer is likely to pursue litigation, the recipient must file caveat in the court concerned to safeguard against ex parte orders. Next is use the right medium to reply to the legal notice. All communications should be made through a proper channel that can be tracked. So sending a reply through a registered post with acknowledgements will be the most conventional way. But in the alternative, like sending the reply through email or WhatsApp, you can exercise all this simultaneously also. The burden is upon the person concerned to prove that the address or the email ID or the mobile number mentioned actually belongs to the person to whom the reply was addressed. So having proper records will come in handy before the courts as well. So look for other ways to resolve the disputes. So there are various ways to resolve disputes at the pre-litigation stage. One is to negotiate with them and find a solution. You could also look for the neutral third party and enter into a mediation or arbitration or Lok Adalats. Recently, a writ petition had been admitted by the Honorable Supreme Court of India seeking a standard operating procedure for pre-litigation disputes resolution. So with respect to commercial disputes, the Parliament of India has mandated pre-institution mediation in some instances and attempts for settle to decrease pendency before various courts. Thank you so much. This is all what one should know about how to deal with a legal notice once it has come to you and how you should deal with such kind of situation. And the first and foremost important thing is not to panic but to stay calm and think wisely when a legal notice has been sent to you. Thank you so much.